Welcome and thank you so much for coming.
We are so excited to celebrate with all of you.
Obviously, I'm Jeff. I'm the guy in the black tuxedo standing next to the beautiful girl in the white dress.
Honey, you really clean up well.
Thanks, babe. I'm from Arcadia, and I work as the Director of Development for the USC Norris Comprehensive Cancer Center.
And I'm from San Diego, and as of 10 minutes ago, my full-time wedding planning job just ended. But I'm normally a physical therapist.
And when this wedding is finally over, and all the planning, we're gonna head to our honeymoon. We're gonna go to Whistler for a week, and then to Fiji for a week.
Yeah.
We're excited. So thanks so much for being here today. But I can remember the first time I asked Jen out on a date. It was April 17th, 2006, Lot K at the Rose Bowl. I knew Jen worked out every day after work, so I came down here to hunt her down. I thought I saw her stretching in the parking lot, but then I thought she wouldn't be wearing those goofy headphones.
These headphones? I love these headphones. I've had them since the 80s. Why would I spend any more money to get anything new? They work great. I had no idea that 2006 would be the year that all my questions would be answered.
Where have all the good men gone, and where are all the gods? Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising odds? Isn't there a white knight upon a fiery steed? Late at night, I toss and I turn and I dream of what I need.
I need a hero. I'm holding out for a hero till the end of the night. He's gotta be strong and he's gotta be fast and he's gotta be fresh from the fight.
I'm calling with the most exciting news I have ever had. Jeff and I got engaged at the Biltmore Ball at what time? 10:30?
10:30-ish.
10:30-ish. No, we were planning to come up here for like weeks to celebrate his birthday. And celebrating his birthday we are doing, for sure. We are more than excited. We are so grateful. I have an incredibly beautiful ring on my finger. It's perfect. I had tears in my eyes when Jeff was reading to me the prayer that he wrote in 97 about the type of woman he desires to marry. And then he read part of his journal. It was so sweet, Mom. He gave me a key to his truck and a key to his parents' house, and then a little Bible with Jen Kliewer on it. I know, it's not so sweet. I told him that I would totally love to have that, you know, eventually. I am so grateful. This is a man I've been praying for.
Will you marry me?
Yes, 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 yes. I love you, I love you, I love you. I love Jeff Kliewer. I love Jeff Kliewer. Jeff and Jen Kliewer.
It's moments like these that make me really miss my dad. Jeff, I'm so proud of who you are and wish I could introduce you to him. Although I was only 6 when my dad passed away, I'm so grateful for the memories I have of him. He loved me, my sister, and my mom so much and was so proud of us. The quality I appreciate about my father the most is that he loved God first. When he was sick, he used to tell my mom often how much he so wanted to get better and live. I would pray each night, God, please heal my dad. On the night my dad passed away, the last words he said were, "Yes, Lord." These are the words my mom chose to put on his headstone, a reminder that Jesus comes first. So the night he passed away, I remember praying, "Thank you, Jesus, for healing my dad. I just wish it was this side of heaven." I'm so grateful that my mom chose at such a difficult time to still believe in God's faithfulness. I can't think of a better gift for a mom to give her daughter than to know who Jesus is. Thank you, Mom, for being a mom and a dad to me for all these years. The quality I appreciate the most about you is that you love God first. Thank you for loving me just for who I am, for supporting me, believing in me, and loving me so much to let me go. Thank you, Mom, for being such a powerful role model in my life of someone who chooses to take one day at a time and make the most of every opportunity. It's such a privilege being your daughter. And thank you, Mom, for welcoming Jeff so warmly into our family. Oh, and by the way, thanks for letting me still store some stuff at your house.
Mom and Dad, thank you for our family. Thank you for showing us what it looks like to have a committed marriage relationship. Most importantly, thank you for loving Jesus first and setting that example. Dad, thank you for teaching me how to lead and for all the fun adventures along the way. And Mom, I know you've prayed for my wife since I was 6 years old. Here she is, our answered prayer. And my two sisters, Liz and Jenny. Liz, thank you for your wisdom over the years. And Jenny, thank you for your consistent prayers. And I'm honored to have both of my brothers-in-law in the wedding today. Mark, who will be singing, was my first big brother. And Jeff, better known as Harley, who will be my best man, is the most generous person I know. Thank you for loving my sisters. And eight of my best friends will be standing up here with me. Billy Coates, who's a great friend of mine. He's a trustworthy man, and I have so much respect for him. Greg Nasser, who finds a positive in everything. He's the one that told me 5 years ago, you gotta meet Jen Yerkey. Sorry, Greg, it took me so long. Dave Burke, former roommate and trusted friend. He's spoken truth into my life for years. Billy Coleman, hands down, the funniest guy I know. We've traveled the world together over 5 continents, but sorry, Billy, I've got a new travel partner now. Mike Foster, the most genuine person you'll ever meet. I love watching how he respects people. Pete Ettinger was my college roommate. He brings a lot of joy and laughter into my life. And Kenny Mills, who I've known for 13 years. He's a consistent friend. He's usually late, but he's a consistent friend. And Aaron Hinojosa, I've known him since I was 14 when we played football together in high school. He was a good guy to know since I weighed 120 pounds. Well, 70 pounds and 22 years later, he's still a great friend.
I'm honored to be standing next to 9 amazing women who I have the privilege of calling friends. Liz Power and Jenny Gilbert, Jeff's sisters, thank you for praying for me over the years. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life loving your little brother. Janice Steverding, my adventurous friend who literally will go anywhere and do anything. I really think the world keeps spinning because of your efforts. And Jen White, my faithful friend and cheerleader, words can't express how meaningful your friendship is to me. Hazel Pereira, my caring friend who literally will do anything for anybody. She's the kind of friend that has your back. Nalani Ball, everything that comes from Nalani is homemade. It's true and straight from her heart. Jill Nearcorn, my friend from first grade. So intelligent and always says it like it is. Kenan Neal, originally my resident director from Westmont College and always my soulmate. You are truly God's faithful servant. And my maid of honor, Allison Yerkey, my big sister who stands right next to me. I respect and love you so much. I literally think it's double trouble and double dose of energy when we're together. I've always loved being your little sister.
And we think 10 of the cutest kids in the world are in our wedding today.
Tanner, Luke, and Eliza Neal.
And my nieces and nephews, Josh, Hannah, and Jake Gilbert. And Brenna and Sophia Power.
And Jeremiah and Riley White. We had so much fun planning the wedding.
I'm just glad we nailed that save the date card picture the first time we took it.
That's not what I remember.
All right, Mark, let's get this show on the road.
Yahoo!